Alrighty, welcome back. I'm your man, Bad Chad, and Queen Jolene's on the camera. We are on air. Fina's in the house. But today we're gonna try to fit this front floor pan in, the passenger side. Gonna try to get it welded in and get it tacked in where it should be, because I think I'm ready. Or I'm not ready, but we're gonna do it on the show here right now, right in front of your very eyes. I got a piece of Bristol board. I've got it cut to shape. I'm just thinking it over at the present moment. As I look to this, I've got a playing field here that's level, a playing field that's here that's level. I got the frame rail welded up to the bottom of the square stock, just like I said I was going to yesterday. I took the jack and put the jack underneath of it, jacked it up and welded it right to that so it's flushed out. What I'm getting is a little bit of gap down there. We've got a playing field there, all the way around. But when I set the paper in, it looks fine. When I set the paper in, it looks A1. I got a little trim a little bit off it to make it fit, and I'll do that here in a second. But as you look at that, and then I do this, trying to see what I got going on here. And the reason I started doing this, or started playing with this little level here and playing with the, you know, the how it's going, is because I got to connect this floor to that frame rail. And sometimes I've done it before where you drill the holes to get it connected to the frame rail and you weld it up, and then your frame rail is down quite a ways and it's harder to get it. You want that frame rail up tight to the floor. It's a hard thing to do unless you put the floor in and you drill the holes and then you're going underneath and whacking it with a hammer and trying to get this edge turned up to the floor, and you're trying to get the floor down tight enough. We're going to see what we can do to get it tight and right. Maybe I can give you a couple little, I'm not sure. You watch and, you know, take what you like and throw away the rest. But as I go up in here, you can see that the frame rail is down just a little bit. You would never get a nice flush weld or a plug weld on that, where you'd have to turn that frame rail up to get to that playing field and get that one turned up. It'd be hard to get a nice plug weld on there. So as you go down a little bit further, it's the same thing. It's down just a little bit. We might try to do something to fix that. But right this present moment, let's make a floor pan for what we got going on. Okay, and if you can understand, when you look underneath, all you're going to see is this lip, that lip, and that lip. Nothing has been welded from underneath, so you're not going to see anything other than that. But we want that floor pan to lay down tight on that, so there's no big gaps, basically. And that's basically what you're going for when you're doing a floor pan. You want something that fits nice all the way around. And sometimes you have to get underneath to make that happen. There's a piece up on this side, right here. This is fine. I'm going to weld along this piece. This is nice. There's a tunnel here. But this must be like a transmission bracket mount, something there. But I'm going to go around that. I'm not going to go down over top of that. I'm going to come out here alongside that and then up there. I'm fine to run over here because that lip there is going to be showing. I can't do nothing with that lip, but I got to run it. You know what I'm trying to tell you is I have to have it, and I want it straight up the front. That's all the stuff I'm trying to check out and make sure that I get right. Let's do this. It's back. It looks bad enough to see, I guess. Let's cut there and see what happens there. Pure scissors. And the nicer job that we get that fitting, the nicer panel we'll have. We're going to use the bead roller to tighten some of the floor pan up. We are. Now, I don't mind that down in there. That's pretty good, actually. That can come back just a little bit further. And it is on an angle like I drew it. Didn't trust my, I drew, cut it off straight, and it is an angle. Now we're able to weld that along there. That fits good. I weld that solid along there, I will. Right there, it's tight. I like it up against that nice and tight. I do. And the reason being is, just makes it fit nice, I guess. Let's cut a little bit off that right here. So if, when I cut this pattern, not if when I cut it, when I cut it, if I cut it, I can easily make it too big, far as that goes, by not cutting the right side of the line. Let's trim this straight. I think that needs to go straight. Yeah, we're fitting up tight, nice there, raw. Gonna come back just a little bit further on that iron, because I got nowhere to weld. I guess I can weld with that piece. Let's cut it back just a little bit further. There's a bunch of shavings in there. And I probably will weld with that piece. It looks like it wants to be welded to the floor anyway, so I might. Just gonna cut it back some, give me a little bit more room. For weld up in there is nice. Now back here I have square stock back here. What I'm going to do there is I'm going to lay this piece of metal over top of it all the way right to the edge, right to there. I'm going to cut my little triangles out of it how I want to put it on there. I'm not going to try to plug weld. I'm not going to drill and all that stuff. I'm going to do a bunch of drilling up there. I'm not going to drill this, I don't think. Well, I might actually where I have the driller, maybe, we'll see. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this piece right all the way to the length with that. And then when I put the back floor in, I'll lay the back floor right on top of that piece and make it go straight across and we'll have a seam. No harm, no foul. Then I just come from underneath and seam seal that side of the square stock, seam seal that side of that square stock. It's over, it's sealed up, it looks good. This seam is nice. I'm not gonna try to bring them together. Generally, you would try to, I got a 3/4 inch there, you would generally try to split it in the middle and then weld it to the square stock. I'm just gonna overlap it. Just thought I'd tell you that just so you know. So if you do it, you can say he done it. Work for him. Basically, that's what I do. If I'm building something, I look how someone else builds something. And what I mean by that is Chev, Ford, Dodge, whatever, Hudson, GMC, if they done it, that just tells me that you can do it. We've got that trimmed off there. And you just, like I said, take what you like and throw away the rest. That's what I do. Always. Information is free. It's how you use it. Isn't it, sweetheart? Mm-hmm. Here it is on this channel anyways, isn't it?
Yeah.
Free. What to do and what not to do. So I do not claim to know everything because I do not. I do not claim to know everything because I don't. But I can weld up an old car. I can. I'm going to cut a little more off that. I think I'll go with that, and then I'll sand it after I get it on. What I mean by sand it is I have a 36 grit sanding wheel. What?
A 36 inch sanding wheel would be pretty good.
That's a big wheel, isn't it? Like the Caucasian, wherever you say it, mustache, 6'3". Ah, it's a big mustache, right? Same thing, Leslie Nielsen. That's pretty tight up in there. I could take just a little bit more off, probably. We'll just take a skim off the whole thing. Not too much, not too little. Just three bears, just right. Stop it. Getting down to hairs there, aren't I? Huh, baby? Getting down to hairs. Not too tight there. Cut a little more off the back again. Trying to get it to fit right. And the reason being is, the better I get it to fit now, the easier it might be. Let's get that piece of metal down. We bought 20 pieces of, you see that? They're going, trying to reach them gloves. We bought 20 sheets of metal from our friend named Fred. This is the last sheet of it. And we bought, I don't know how many sheets of, 20 sheets of 18 gauge. And this is the last sheet. I'm kind of wondering how many body shops this year used 20 sheets of 18 gauge. A lot of metal. Me and Doug did the doodle bug. I think I'm thinking that took a lot of metal, obviously. But we've used a lot of metal here. I'm gonna just clean off this little bit of rust. We'll make that panel. It's 18 gauge. It's 18 gauge. Now, what I want to do, pit it quite heavy, isn't it? Go this edge. That's the longest edge. Let's do it. Put on that one. Stop it. So we're going to put a couple beads in this, and I think we're going to step it down in a place. And I'm thinking we're going to step this piece down where the frame rail looks like it's stepped down, because I want that frame rail tight to this piece of metal when you look underneath the car. I want it to look clean. I want it to look... I was saying to Jolene yesterday, doing this to this Volvo, basically it wasn't what I was, wasn't something that I was seeking out to do. We met the man at the auction that day, at the car auction, and he said he had a Volvo for sale, and it just morphed into that. It's funny how sometimes you're doing things, and it's the reason because of a decision you've made. And the decision we made that day was go to the auction, have fun. We end up meeting somebody, and now we're on to a Volvo. It's not something that I would ever think of to customize, but basically it was a pretty interesting car. I guess that's why we're at it. But we're really bringing a car back to life. When you look at this one with the sills we put on it and the trunk that we've done and that sort of stuff, you can think to yourself how many people would have bought this car to restore. I'm not sure. Cutting the line because the pattern's inside the line, right? That's the pattern. Pattern is inside that line. That's why I'm cutting the line. Paper pattern, first thing you do. We have an order of operations on this one, and I'm going to show you my order of operations here in a second, as soon as I get this piece of metal dealt with. I think I'll use the sander to sand it off. I've got it plugged in right here, all ready to rock and roll. Cut this little piece out on the side. Got our panel cut. This is something, well, let's do this. No, let's do this first. This is something I think that I probably have should have been doing with all the pieces that I put on. We generally do polish the pieces once we put them on the car, you know, you polish it. But in all honesty, I should, prep each piece of metal when I put it in. So when I come in here to the floor and I want to apply that piece of metal in there, it basically should be prepped. What I mean by prepped is sand it so I can put on the rocker guard. And if it's not prepped underneath, well, basically it's going to be hard to, you know, expect that rock guard or anything to stick to the underneath of it if it's not prepped. And it's hard to prep when you've got a frame rail in the middle of it. So basically what I should be doing more of is prepping it with this, each piece. And take what you like, throw away the rest. Side of the line. No, all I'm doing is right there is just prepping the metal to go in there. So if I want to apply something to it without having to go back in and scratch it, this is what's doing. I guess now I'm allowed to apply anything to it I want, like primer, body fill. Well, I don't know if I go put body fill on it, but at least it would stick better if it wasn't sanded. Alrighty. Just thought like we thought it would fit. Now what I'm gonna do is, now I know that this is still up off that frame rail. And the reason being is I'm gonna put something on top of it. Let's do this. Or something even heavier, maybe. Hold it down. I'm going to go and take a look underneath of it and see what's going on. Not bad. See, it's got a little tiny gap going on right there. You see that? Not bad going along back there, though. Just like we thought it was. It's nice. All right. Got a little bit of gap going up in the front. This is what I'm going to do. All right, we know that's in there. I'm going to put a pair of vice grips on it, or channel locks, so it'll stay where I want it to. I'm just going to click it on the back. In this process here, I'm going to have to do the exact same thing to the other side, no doubt in my mind. Just going to go here. We're not quite flush all the way across the back. Well, we are now. Really nice. Weld that along there. Weld that along there. Really nice. Let's do this. Now we're going to find where that frame rail is. We're going to drill some holes in it so we can spot weld the floor that we've made to the bottom of the car. That's how tight that fits. Piece of paper. And it doesn't start fitting good till about there. You can see that gap all the way here. See that gap through here? Mm-hmm. I don't really want to beat that up and just get that tip. I want it to fit, you know? It'd be nice if it fit. Slide underneath here a little bit. Go to the other side. Back across there. I'll just use that one there to do the exact same thing. So I made a line right here, and that's where it's acceptable here to put the spot welds in here. up here is not acceptable. We're a little ways off, and I'm going to fix it. Let me look better. On the sides, I think it's pretty decent. I have to hammer it down, I suppose, like anything else. Probably use a piece of wood in there or something, maybe. Now, take this off. Hope I get my steps correct. Now, I'm gonna say that's there. I'm gonna say that, well, that's the front, obviously. So we have, that's our frame rail. So we have to drill our hole within that piece. I should have traced it off here in the back side. Draw that on the inside. It's basically where the holes have got to go. At the ends, I'm just going to V it out, drill the holes here. Up in the toe board. This is the toe board up here. This is the bottom of it. So I'm just using this to drill holes in here. Let's drill some holes. Figure it out as we go. Nope. Yep, let's drill some holes. Figure it out as we go. So this right now I'm going to drill the holes for the frame rail. And I just guessed with that mark, you can see how wide the frame rail is. You can see how wide this piece is. That's what I'm trying to hit with a plug weld. That's what I'm trying to hit. Like I said, I can take it from underneath and nail it up to the floor and tack on the outside there. I won't like the look of it. I won't like the look of it. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to put this on the floor. Do it this way. This is the lip there. I'm going to put it right here. See if I can. Oops. A little on the outside there, didn't I? I don't think too far. We'll bring her back in a little bit. Quite a few plug welds, but see how fast I can do this. And I had been doing my 50 push-ups. I apologize that it did not was on that camera, but I had forgot a couple times there, and I made sure I jumped right down and done them. Jolene's my witness.
Yep, you did.
Yes, I did. I went for it. I went for it. Not measuring out the spot welds on this right now, and I'll tell you why. They didn't. That's why. Hope that makes sense. And it's faster not to measure them out. You can measure them out if you want to. I'm a guessing kind of guy, but I don't like to gamble. I guess what you would call me is an experienced guesser. I guess that's what you call me, an experienced guesser. Let's flap and reel all these off. A lot of them, but. In order for me to make that frame rail do its job, that's basically what I think that needs to be done. Let's stick it on there. There's our frame rail. See it all the way up there. Now we're quite a ways away up front there. So remember that thing we had there? We're actually going to run, this is what I'm going to do. We're going to run a couple lines in this bad boy.
I have a question.
What's that? Jolene has a question.
Where the frame rail is doesn't hit the metal, like would you use your third arm to make the metal go down to that frame rail?
I can, but what happens is you end up, generally, you can't get in there, down in there.
Okay.
And then it ends up, you push it down there, you're denting the metal or you're hitting it with a hammer. And I'm going to try to stay away from hitting it with a hammer. That's what I'm going to try to stay away from, hit it with a hammer. Just got this fit on here, nice as one, nice straight line. Let's put one. Move it over a little bit because I get a little bit of an idea on what I want to do here. I'm going to put a line there. Jeez. And we'll put a line over here. I can cut it off wherever I want. Not a very good line, but now let's go put a bead in that. What I want to do is put a bead in that to make it stronger. And then I'm gonna do something else after that, I guess. Or maybe I should do that first. Nope. Let's go in here for a second. Thanks for coming back. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all the comments. Thanks for everything. We really appreciate it. And what I have here now is, I'm going to put it right in the center of that line. I have a bead roller in this thing, bead roller right now. I've got a die that I had made, so this is a homemade die. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to put a line down through this, just because, try to strengthen her up a little bit. I don't know if I want to hum dad in that nut too much or not. If you want to roll me through, sweetheart, I'll do the best I can do to make a straight line. Joan's using all her muscles. All of her muscles. Atta girl, all of her muscles. She's my lady. Beautiful. Yeah, let's take that off. Get on there now. Side. We'll start about the same area. Can't see the hump. Yeah, I can see it now. We'll do. If it's not perfectly straight, it's in the floor of the car. We won't worry about it a whole bunch. Now, that thing come off. Nope, let's do this. Not staying straight there, is it? All right, let's try it, see what happens. You've been doing push-ups?
Yeah, I have been.
Have you?
Well, tricep push-ups.
Did you hear that voice? Tricep push-ups. Further?
Oh, keep going, sorry.
Please.
I couldn't see the line.
Please. Beautiful. Well done, Jolene. Ah! Be better if this was turned straight, maybe. That's all right. Turn that out. All right, we got two lines in it so far. Let's go put that in there for a second. Just two lines by eye. That's basically what we got going on there. Just two lines by eye. Step down for some strength. You can see it on that side. Just step down for some strength. Yeah. We're still hunky-dory. Nothing's hitting anything. That's just want to make sure the lines aren't hitting anything. Now we're going to this part. Let's make this fit. What this is what I'm thinking. We're fitting tight and right up there where the piece of the one, the 3/4 inch come down. It's fitting pretty good there. It's not fitting down there. You can see I'd have to hammer that down there quite a ways to get that. We've got a step bit, so I feel like we should step it down. Basically, that's what I'm thinking. So the quicker I change that step bit, the better it would be. And do this. You can even pause it if you wanted to. Nope, let's do it. This is the time it takes to change this, as I'm gonna show you. Take those two bad boys off. I've got a... And it fights with you. Pull that one off. Yeah, we want the step bit. This is the right, this is the top. We want to step that down to that frame rail. So that steps it down, would it not? This is gonna be out. That steps it down. Got to be careful on this, because if you don't get the, if you don't put these on right, it don't do the right job. We'll actually check it before we do it. So let's put this on here. Put that on there. Give me a piece of metal real quick. I'll get a piece. Got to be careful on that. I've done it too many times. When you roll it through, it doesn't do the job that you think it's going to do. Then you end up changing it. Roll through. We're stepping her down. Good. So now we're going to run it from the top. We're going to step that down a little bit. First, we're going to tighten it up with a different wrench. Got to get it on the flat spot. There she be, on the flat spot. Yeah, can you roll this one around, sweetheart? Just turn that one. No, the other way. Right there. Hold there, please, and just putting this on. So this little pin hits the flat spot on the roller there. Thanks, Fina. You're doing a fantastic job. Fantastic. Put this on. Sometimes it takes more time to change these than it does to get the job done, but it's part of the job. Part of the job. All right. Now I got to draw a line on this bad boy that I want to follow for. And I'm going to do it with tape. Looking. My marker's marked out, I think. Now I'm going to go with those two lines I got. How far back am I going? Right to this one right here. Now we want to keep it straight. We want to step it down. I'm going to go straight with this line if I can. 3/4 inch away. Remember? I'm asking Jolene to remember, but she's just filming. She's not remembering. 3/4 inch away. That's where it lays on the, where the footboard is. That's nice. But the frame rail's down a little bit where this plug weld's on. I take a look at that for a second. I'm like, which line would you... I think I like it so it's tighter, if you know what I'm trying to tell you. So it's tighter like that. Would you go on that side? Who's building this car, me or you, what? Let's go for it. Let's do it. Put that on there. We're just gonna step this down and hopefully we can have something that fits that. Now. So we're stepping that down, aren't we? That's what we want. We want this. We want this. We want it all stepped down, so.
So wouldn't you do the middle of the...
No. I'm going to do this part right on this side. Thinking. Wouldn't I? And it wouldn't start until 3/4 of an inch. So it lays flat. And that steps it down. All right, we're going to go for it. That step, just a minute. That part wants to go down, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I got it wrong already, didn't I? Huh?
I'm not sure, but...
Just put a dent in that, I did. I have to roll it from the other way. Did that make a difference? No. Why can't I figure this out here a second? That rolls it like that. We want to step that down. So we want to do it from the other side. So if that goes like that, it steps that down.
Mm-hmm. That's
right.
Yeah.
That's got it stepped up though.
Because you want to be on this side of the line then. And then we'll step that down.
No, I'd, like no. I want to be on the outside of the frame rail. Mm-hmm. And I want to step this all down. If I turn it around, it steps it down. If I come in from this way, it steps it down. Mm-hmm. Does it not?
Do you want to grab another bigger piece just to try?
No, it doesn't step it down. Ah, hurting my brain. Let's roll it. That does that. Steps it down. Now. That's what I want to do to that. Step it down. Isn't that right? Step that down. That's what I say. Step it down. Let's try it. Go ahead. Yeah, she's having fun.
She's doing. Holy smokes.
Good. I think that worked. Here we go. Huh? Step that down, hit that frame rail. Beautiful. Took a little bit on the old noggin, it did. Just a minute now. Oh. That one's gonna be done this way. Right? Ah, hurting my old brain. And I'm going to kick it over there a little bit and do my own line, I guess, because it's just way off. Go ahead. Cool. Oh, sorry. I don't like swear how I got that, but not bad. Not bad. Just gonna take it here and tap it with a hammer. Where I bent that first piece. It's pretty good. All right. Let's get a clamp. I'm happy. What's that? Yeah, I'm happy with that. Let's just check out from. Now I got to put some V's in there, I think. Flush that off. That is a lot of spot welds on that floor. Now, if I take the hammer, something to hold that down. I want to check it from underneath, that's all. What's that? You can. Okay, it's helped. It ain't done at all, that's for sure. But I'm going to start playing with it right now. Let's put it in. Now, actually, I'm going to do this first. Up across the front. How am I going to do that? I'm just going to tack the sides because it's quicker. It's faster. Right here, I'm going to take a V out of it because I'm just going to weld that shut. And I'm going to flush that off smooth. And we're going to lay the next panel that comes up here to it. We're just going to lay right over top of it. We're not going to try to split it in the middle. Up front. The only reason I drill any holes there is I want to get that frame rail connected. That's the only reason. Up front, what I'll probably end up doing, we have a lip going across there. It lays on top. I'll probably just end up spotting it across the front so it looks tight and right. It's all going to be seam sealed anyways, just as long as it's tight and right. Let's do this. Just mark that. If you have a brain fart, like I had in there with the thing, take your time, just brain fart it out. Basically what happened here is we've got that frame rail, we've got that center of that piece of metal dropped down, you know, I'd say almost a quarter of an inch down there to help it take up the place where it had that gap. And it will, once we get going, let's get her going. Let's cut these out of it. That clean back off. Anything with a marker on it, you go to paint it, it's coming back through. Now, I said I was going to do that, didn't I? I might as well straighten that out while it's out here. See how I got that bead rolling in there? I might as well straighten that out. Before I put it in there, just cause me havoc. Havoc! Like to have that out of the way. I guess basically if I want it out of the way, I just move it, I guess. I bring out a hammer. Yeah. I just want to pound these flat, that's all. A lot of that stuff you can just bend by hand also. Just take your time. I'm playing with 18 gauge. That's what I'm playing with. It's a nice piece of metal. You're able to grind a little bit off and still feel comfortable, as far as I'm concerned, when you use 18 gauge. Just kind of wondering if I shouldn't do the same thing up front with the V's, and then you could grind it off and hide it. Still gonna seam seal it, don't matter. Don't matter. Anything down in here that's on top, it does basically not matter a whole lot, because you're gonna be seam sealing and then carpeting or whatever. Frame rail won't do nothing to that until it's over. And the reason being, I start throwing undercoating or anything like that on it, it's gonna seep everywhere. There's a hole up inside the front of this frame rail, and that's where you shove it into, or if you want to shove another hole in somewhere, and then you throw a bunch of oil inside it, or undercoating, or whatever you want to do. And I'm thinking that would help you, or help the process. Let's do that. What I like about narrow ways, now if it's not completely tight, if you don't get it completely tight, this is what I'm going to say. When we get it down there, if we can't get it completely tight, that's when we have to go from underneath and knock them little two frame rail 90s up in the air so we can attach it to the floor. But I did the best I could do, or I think I have, to make it work. And I think it will work, without a doubt. Dun, 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 dun. Everything's so nice and pretty. It's getting clean. It's getting nice. This stuff just going to take one floor pan at a time, and try to do a fairly nice job of it. And then I'll be happy in the end. But basically the first thing I gotta do when we get starting something like this, you really want to make sure, tack it once, and then come back to it and see if you're happy. Like, do not just start welding it in and think you're gonna be okay. Tack it somewheres. Look it all over, and then go for it. Got my air with me. Another thing too, when you're doing a floor like this, you do not want to start zonking the welds to it. That's a flat sheet of metal of 18 gauge with a couple bead rolls in that. I've got it stretched right now. You can tell it's stretched because it's doing that. You can tell it's stretched, but what I'm trying to say is, do not come in and run a great big bunch of welds on your sheet of metal and thinking that you're welding her down and you're happy. Now that stuff, that floor panel will warp just like anything else. Probably warp faster than anything else. Yeah. Got my hammer in here. Did I leave that in there? Not my gloves in there, but it fell out of the sky for me. Take that one. There it is right there, Lil. Did you know that? Just making sure that's down tight, that's all. Looking her all over, even before I zap one on her. Looking her all over. Everything fits. Alrighty. Just knock her on right here. We know we got one tack. You still can move it. If you want to, you can move it. Don't feel it's necessary. Let's come over here. Let's knock that down nice and tight. And the thing I'm going to do on the end here, where I took that V out. I'm just gonna flatten them off with the flapper wheel. Flatten them off this way, flatten that way. Then I'll come over and lay my sheet right over top of it. We'll do a nice overlay there. Just like that. Two tacks of weld and that metal popped up. Now, what I got going on here is I got two tacks of weld on it, so I'm saying that we're done. I'm saying that it's over. Like, let's weld it on. And that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna put one, I'm gonna put a spot of weld up here. See if I can't. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna spot it so it stays. Did it stay down, did it? I don't think it did it? Nope. That's the thing with spot welds. Yeah. Do that again and get that to stay there. One thing I didn't do, and I should have, probably should have cleaned that frame rail up just a little bit more. Let's get some air on that. Want to finish this one off? It's tight. Thinking that we're tight up front. I know we're tight up front. I want to get a pair of gloves on. I'm going to try not to, bang on the floor with a hammer. I start banging on the floor with a hammer, then the panel's not going to look good anymore. Because all it's doing is going to cause a dent if I can stand it. Sure, I can stand it. Sure, I can stand it. So we're going to get. That's really tight down there. Seems to be really tight going on there. So I'm going to nail it right there. Must be scared of the welder. I'm shaky. Yeah. I really actually like that one there too. Nice new metal. I'll tack that in there as nice as possible. Remember I said I wasn't going to hit it? On the edge I will. Ooh, that's nice. Plays real nice along there. Beautiful. This one's tight. Just keep going around trying to find the whatever's laying down the nicest. We're up here in the corner. edge is where I'm going, just on the edge, whether you can't see it. Nice. Welded my little rod. Trying to keep it a good distance away so I don't warp nothing. Slipped on that one, I did. It's all right. Alrighty, we're good around the outside edge, I'm thinking. Might want to put one in between each one of those after a little bit. Now, just up here, get this tight. Just kind of working my way around, getting everything down tight. And I still sort of want to leave a gap. I want all my spot welds. I want all my spot welds sort of same distance apart. They look good when it's all welded together is what I'm looking for. Ouch, it's still hot. We're good here. Let's put one on. We're tight and right. Take a little air. Let's give it a little air, boy. Quite a bit to it, actually. You know, I could throw all four panels in real quick and say, there you go. But there's quite a bit of work, actually, to make them fit right. Nicer, much happier about that. When it's tied down, or when it's knocked down, that's when the metal behaves its best. It's when it's knocked down like that, and then I can tap it and it will go down further. We got a couple spots of weld up there. I knew it. I just didn't pay attention to it. Let's get something going on. Let's get this toe board down. Ah, hard spot. Yeah. There. That nailed down. Where I'm hitting it with a hammer now, you wouldn't see it on the other side. It's got that lip. Let's get this to work. I'm going to put a piece of wood there. I'm going to put a piece of wood in there, and I'm going to hit it real hard. That's what I'm going to do. Come on. That's tight up against that weld, so I'm going to weld it or nail it. Air cord won't leave that welding cord alone, will it? What I'm going to do is I'm going to get a grab a piece of wood right there. The piece on the part that we kicked down, the step down that we did. I think it could go down a little bit. See what happens. We'll hit it with this. Make some noise. Coming down now. See how that come down? See how tight that come down? Almost right on top of it. Beautiful, I say. Beautiful. Now, boom, 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 boom. Now I can do this. I gotta take a look from underneath. See if it needs to be tapped up or not, because basically that's what it could need. It could need a tap up instead of a tap down. Tap up, tap down. Just make that frame rail fit better. Ooh, that looks good. Doesn't it? Mm-hmm. That looks right on the money, man. Right on the money! That looks good. So the step down that we did the trick. Like, that's awesome. That worked out. And I'm gonna say, it looks really good right there, and I'm gonna nail it on there. One right there looks really good right there, and it's in the middle. So of what happened to my helmet would have to be the time, wouldn't it?
Is it my light?
What?
Is it my flashlight?
Yeah, flat maybe. Ruined my spot weld, it did. I have to grind that out of there because I got a bunch of weld in there, and it just kind of now that's what I'm talking about right there. As soon as you mess one of them plug welds up, it's over. Something happened to the helmet, bud. Well, that's not fair. Bugger my helmet up just because I dropped it. Max delay, battery sensitivity, shade. I have no idea. No idea. Let's try this one back here again. That one's no good either. Can't see in that one. Well, I can't see right at the present moment welding, so. I don't know what happened to it. We'll blow this one off and go for it. Try it. But I can't see, so. Still can't see. That one worked. Um,
lock one in the center, I guess. There we go. Yeah. Can I get a hammer? You need to go out, Fina? Jolene will show you the door. Doesn't hurt to have every different kind of hammer you got. Out. Not a place to work, but. Do it. Going easy on the metal underneath on that frame rail because it's, you know, it's been ground, it's been welded, it's been just a little bit of everything. You really want to move around on something like this because if you don't, everything's tight. Is now. Let's get one of these suckers over here. That holds it. I doubt it. Awesome. Thank you. reach one up here a little further. Give it a little bump. There. Ah. Guess you got her. Now I'm thinking with that one, I should be able to knock these ones down tighter. Knock them down. Just want to get them down tighter. One of these hammers on this side. I'm thinking that we're down. Weld, set some air on it. Not going nowhere. Sometimes when it spits and sputters on you, just stay with it. Stay with it, basically. Almost done. Stick with me. Stick with me. Ouch, that's hot. Joey, just let me know she's still with me, standing on my cords. Hi, baby. You still with me?
Yeah.
Gotta give Jolene credit coming over here every day and working every day to get everything done. If you're working on your project, pat yourself on the back. Let yourself, you know, you've done a good job, if you have. If you haven't, we'll go back over it. It's not too late. It's not too late. Now, I'm gonna push it down. Got a spot in between each one of those, and then we're gonna spot that and be done with it. Thank you. Bit of air on that. We don't want to get nothing too hot. That one up here we'll get held down. It's nice. Actually, just there is a difference when you hold them down. You might think that you're tight and right, but. This side here and get all the spot welds looking the same. Some air on before I go too far. Okay, just join it now. Let's finish it. Job splitting my welds up there, that's for sure. No, I did not. You know what fixes that is more. Be able to lay my hand on that floor and not get burnt. You got that right. It's all good. Let's go up front here and finish these spot welds, and then we'll call this one floor pan in. And then I got a bunch of work to do. And that's to make the other one look like this one. Let's get them welded up here. Tap on it and see. All right. Get the grinder. Get the grinder right off. Got a bit of heat there. Can't forget this lonesome soldier. That's the hardest thing about putting in a floor pan, I would say, is getting the frame rail knocked down tight where it should be to make yourself happy from looking underneath. I know what it is now. I was putting my helmet over top of my red thing. It wasn't flashing off for me. Put my hand over my head, like this, doing like this, over top of the helmet. was taking away my, those are like, I can't ask no better than that. I don't thank them too. Them two spot welds like that, I'm not dealt with air, could warp your floor. That's how easy that is. I think that was the one that needed it. Couple left up front, and I'm saying that we're putting the gas. Man, I'm just taking my hammer. Just making sure we fit good. That's all. I'm gonna weld them two up. I think it looks good. It does look good. Well, not good. Beautiful. Take this over here. That over there. Lord knows that we'll need it for the other side. Now. We're not going to get no tighter floor than that. We've got that all welded to the frame rail. We've got two nice, we got a nice bead there. We got a nice bead going on there. And we got a step down there for to fit the frame rail. So it fits the frame rail nice. That is in there tight and right. That's a really nice floor pan for this car. And the reason being is it's going to hold it tight and right because I've got it connected everywhere is right. As far as I'm concerned. The only reason I'm not doing the plug welds down the side and up the front and down the other side because of time. It takes a lot of time to make that, to plug weld that all the way around there and bead and pound and make sure it's all down tight. When you're spotting it on the way I am, you really can just jam your third arm down in and make sure it gets tight and nail it. When you get that plug weld, sometimes you're not sure. Also, I prefer to do it this way on the floor part because it's all going to get buried. And I know that I'm welded in there. When you're not sure, like this stuff here, I mean, let's face it, to me, that all felt fantastic going on. But to me, like, you have no idea whether that's gonna pop off sometime or not. You're not really sure, to be honest with you. With it veed in like that, I know I got penetration in because I worked it right to it. But that there on the edge there, I feel like, what do I feel? I feel that's fine. And the reason being is, we'll come in there with seam sealer and that sort of stuff, and we'll gear that up. Everything from underneath has got a lip, so I'll be able to seam seal that off nice. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. It's the end of the day. I appreciate everybody coming back. Subscribe if you like, throw in a comment if you like, grab a project and work along with if you like, but we appreciate you coming back every day. I owe you 50, I got you 50 yesterday. No, I owe myself 50. I owe myself 50. Have a great day, everybody. Come back tomorrow and we'll be here. An extra three just for the shits of it. Thanks a lot, everybody, for coming back. We really appreciate it. Take what you like, throw away the rest.
Come back tomorrow and we will be here.